Sometimes it's good to just relax and sit back and listen to a record. I remember listening to music when I was growing up, and you opened up the jacket and you were reading the lyrics and you saw the pictures and like, oh, I wonder what was going through their head. And this is an ode to that time. It's a complete story. There's ups and downs. There's really high moments. There's fun, energetic moments. I would want people to take the journey of the record.
Don't let go of my hand, don't move a thing. I want to stay like this forever, what you say. We can laugh and we can kiss, stay in bed for 30 days. It's what you wish, I hope it is. And I hope it
Music's changed my life. You remember smells, you remember sights, buildings, things that from your childhood on, and you'll have a feeling from it. Music does the same. Like if I hear a song, it takes me right back to wherever I was when I heard the song, or maybe something was going on in your life and it helped you get through something. I definitely try to write songs that have meaning. I followed my heart and I followed where it took us. And I don't know. Everyone's done an amazing job. And the recreation, I think, this evening was fantastic.
Time we did. So we met, gosh, probably 6-7 years ago. I was working at a bar. He was playing a gig there. And some friends of mine, friends of his, said, no, Dave, you should go sing a song with Pat. So he brought me up. We did a song together and kind of just took off from there. And it's really grown into a great friendship and a great musical partnership since then.
We went and saw him play at the Rhino. And I remember just being taken aback by his talent. You know, he's playing a lot of covers, but then when he played his originals, I was like, dude, this is unreal.
I've known Patrick for years and years. We kind of do the same thing. We play at a lot of the same places, do a lot of the same sort of things, but don't get to spend a lot of time on the same stage. And that's definitely been true with me and Patrick. We don't get to cross paths that often, and it's a really kind of a special experience when you get to do that.
I got a call from Patrick to come play bass, and he said, hey, I want to do something different for the release. I've got this idea. So this was sort of Patrick's brainchild, the album and this concept, but I was completely in it when he told me, you know, what we were planning to do tonight.
I think this is the best depiction of his talent, his songwriting abilities. I just think it's the best work he's done so far, so I'm really happy to be a part of it.
Comfortable, warm, and free. Leave
I really liked Gone Are the Days. Just the feel, the vibe that we had being here all day recording, like I just felt like it finally had hit that moment.
I think Patrick really wanted us to be able to breathe life into all these songs, and I think we all managed to do that in different ways. But I think that one was one in particular that had a certain sort of open-endedness as far as the live performance.
And I think that was a perfect example of me serving the song what he was hearing, what he was desiring, and just living that vicariously through my fingers. But then also, I had the opportunity to put my character on it. So I think it sounds like me, and it still sounds like him. You know, it still sounds like a Pat Rock song, so.
Oh,
Patrick is a great songwriter, a great brother, a great father, a great human being. I love him very much. The guy is just a prolific songwriter. He's very good at what he does.
Patrick was really adamant about us calling this a celebration rather than a reproduction, and really kind of putting our own selves into it a little bit. So it was kind of an interesting experience.
It's nice to hear somebody else react to what you played, or vice versa, and just kind of feed off that energy.
I always write about love. I always write about hope. Love has so many facets that it's a never-ending subject. You can always find something. There's positive, there's bad love, there's so many things. There's acts of passion, there's acts of, you know, whatever it may be, but I don't find it dull at all, you know, because we all want to be happy, we all want to succeed, we all want to have a little nudge to. A lot of times, you know, if you put on a song, it can take you to a place, you know? And some of these songs on this record will take you to, most of them will take you to a place whether you want to or not.
Love.
some of the decisions musically were completely different than Inception. A song like Let's Kiss was written on the guitar, but it wasn't right. And when we got into the studio, I was talking to my buddy Joey, and I was like, man, can you play these chords on the piano? And he started doing them on the piano, and the whole mood changed, and it really came to life for me. Then the way that we're able to celebrate it this evening, where the basis of it is there, but the changes and the musicality of everyone really just putting in their own work, it brought it to another level.
Such a perfect body, by chance bumped into mine, ships on the ocean, we were destined to collide, baby it's amazing.
Something to Lose was a song about, you know, a dear friend of mine who passed, Chris Carroll. We played together for a long time. You know, one of the ways that I dealt with his passing was to write a song to honor him. And I was able to bring in on the recording some of his bandmates that played with him throughout the years, and his wife sang some backing tracks. So that meant a lot to me. I enjoyed that one tonight, for sure.
Thank you.
drums are an outlet to me. Drums are therapy. Drums are a way for me to accompany, thankfully, good musicians that I've been blessed to be able to play with.
To me, it's I mean, yeah, if without music, like, life would just suck. It's a way for me to express emotions, but also sometimes it's a way to really kind of dial in and clarify what I'm feeling.
Playing bass has been everything, and it's really all I've wanted to do musically. I've ventured into a few other instruments through the years, but I always land back at bass. I'm a bass player.
What it means for me is everything. Joy, happiness, because I love the other records so much. So to be a part of one, yeah, it's awesome. Just totally lucky and grateful.
It's been a joy for me to watch, in particular, to watch Matt and Patrick sort of interact as guitar players, because I think they're both phenomenal guitar players, and but very different players. And I think it's really the spirit of this whole project.
In the song Lately, right, it says, when I hear that song, it takes me right back to that place. You know, and that's like, to me, that's what music is. It's a way that, you know, when we create it, it's a way to kind of express, you know, a feeling or a mindset or something that we're going through.
When I see a problem, I run. The walls that you build and they must weigh a ton. And I'm sorry I haven't been much fun. But I can't control these fears. You said that you in your heart that one day I'd be good and weak.
I guess as a songwriter, when you're writing a song and it comes to you, I can hear all the parts, but to have someone that you trust, that you enable to take the song to a different level, it's everyone on the stage, they're the ones that you want to call, you know? And I was lucky and blessed that they were able to do it and they wanted to do it, you know?